We've made it. 30 episodes. How are we going to celebrate? With this guy. My old enemy. That's right. We are going to farm gas. I've been super, super busy and super, super stoked from... Hello, Slimes. The amount of views... My iron farm tutorial was getting is pretty cool. As soon as I say that, no golem spawn. That's typical. Anyway, let's show you guys what I've been up to. My mini Nether Hub has improved drastically, as you can see. We have multiple levels now because. You know, I've got too many tunnels. I finally got this zombie pigman head. I still don't have the ordinary spider head though. And I still haven't done the tunnel to the witch hut. But, down here is fresh, you know. And I've built a very, very short tunnel to my industrial farm. And I will show you all of this in a minute. First, let's have a peek here. The episode we built this is called The Realm Destroyer, if you wanted to go back and see that. But this brings us to my farming area. And yeah, got a nice quick way there now. So, this is the Ghast Farm. Over there is the spawning platforms. I'll take a minute to describe some of this while we're waiting for a ghast to spawn. I won't cut the video so you can actually see how it all works actually like in real time, but there's some lava with trapdoors running through the middle of that platform and some dogs up in the sides sort of trying to spook those skeletons that spawn in here, but it's not working too well. Anyway, this half of the farm is a soul sand valley, and the half behind me is a crimson biome. So the ghasts will only spawn this side, and then I transport them to the other side. So you know, it kind of keeps them spawning, really. Obviously. Rates aren't amazing because it is ghasts. Oh, got one. Right, so we hit this button, send off our minecart, and usually it gets them pretty quick. There you go. Now we've got him, we can hit this lever. So that's moved that track, that will bring our ghast to the other section of the farm. And it's the name tag area. So here, basically, if we decide we want to keep the ghast, we can name him. Here is my switch, death and life. I want to show you first how we end these guys. Press the button, new minecart, sends him on his way over here to the kill chamber. And then here we just swing at him, and you know, standard. His drops will go up this item elevator. I put glass there because I love looking at it, and into this sorting system. The broken minecarts will cruise straight over the system and get funneled all the way back to the droppers. Or dispensers rather, one here, one back the other side. Now, basically if there was a ghast in there, that's what happens, and then that minecart comes back. Now I want to show you if we want to keep the ghast, we flick this switch to life, hit the button again, imagine we've got a ghast in there. That'll trigger some redstone which lights the portal. Then there's some delay. some lava dispensers, breaks the portal, and then the lava turns itself off. It's all pretty cool stuff. I do want to show you that actually working properly, so we'll cruise up here and wait. No, we don't need to wait, there's another one. So let's close that off. That will keep the cart going in there until we've picked one up. Send another one in there, try and speed this up a little bit. Oh, we've already got him. Right, bring him through. Now obviously, because this guy's going to live, we actually do want to name him. I've got a name tag here. He is Tej. Tej, you get to live. So, let's send him off. He take a tiny bit of damage from that cactus, but it's nothing much. And he's gone. All works. All good. Very happy with it. One of my favourite farms. Now we need to go and see where I've sent him. He should be somewhere near spawn. I mean, I did build the portal that end, so I know exactly where it is. We'd better sleep that rain off, actually. That is terrible for videos. That's ironic. We're in the ghast head. Couldn't make that stuff up. Right. The area now that we've sent our court ghast to is over by the Leshen. So there's Godzilla. That's the industrial farming area that we showed you. There's a Snakes and Ladders minigame. There's a Leshen just rendered in. And there is the captured ghast area. And I do hope he's there. Be a crappy video if he wasn't. He's there. He's there. He's in. Oop. Yeah, he's there. I'm too far away. Awesome. So, what we've got going on here now is simple little dispenser. The cart will go round in circles indefinitely. That's brilliant. That is brilliant. And when the time comes, which isn't yet, you can flick that switch, it'll move the track, and then you can take your ghast off to wherever you want. I'm using them to farm things, but that won't be in this episode. Maybe the next episode we'll have a ghast powered tree farm or something like that. And yeah, that is pretty much all the farm. I just need to decorate this. I'm not sure how or what to do. But cool. It does still work. But sometimes this happens. I found about four of them doing this once. Come on. What? Oh, look at him. Bopping his head like he's some sort of gangster. Yeah. Get in your hole, fool. Anyway, guys, I had an idea on how to decorate. Let's go. Basically, I've got to get loads of concrete, loads of wool. Maybe a few other bits, I can't remember. Hey! Our first ghast is squished. Oh dear. I'm gonna do some shopping, I'm gonna speed up the video, and catch you when we get back. So I've turned all the concrete powder I've just bought into actual concrete. I know I'd pay double if someone just did it for me. But we've got the start of a build. If I can get up here, it really... That'd be really helpful. So, I thought big white box, almost square. How are we gonna decorate this? And then my daughter actually said, "Oh, Dad, why don't you just make a big cast?" So I'm gonna do my best to make it cast-like, not pixel for pixel. Because it's glass. But I'm just getting a few of these sort of weird stripes that he's got going around his body. And let's have a look at this. Oh my God, that is hideous. I love it. Alright, so I've just got to get a few of these legs, or what are the tentacles? I don't know what they are. Appendages. And then we're done. You know, I'm not going crazy with this build. It is sort of meant to be just a... I don't know what you call it. A gas train station. Or something. Anyway, I'm kind of happy with it. Let's cruise on up here and have a quick look at it, and then that will be the Ghast farm, completely complete. That is hilarious. With those eyebrows, that's hilarious. I love it. I'm gonna sit here and muck about and see what sort of drops I get, how many casts I get for a little while. Just from having this thing running for about a day, I'm sort of getting a cast every 3 or 4 minutes, which is not that bad. Anyway, I squeezed a lot into this, so I'm going to call this the end of the episode. And thanks everybody that's been following this series on Bedrock in Wonderland. I can't believe we've made 30 episodes. It's nuts. Anyway, if you enjoyed any of this, please drop a like and subscribe. And I will catch you all in the next episode, where hopefully we'll actually get to play with some of the ghasts that we've stolen. Yeah. Anyway, guys, have a good one. See you later. Peace out. Oh, and yeah, I've fixed him. He's stuck in there now. He won't be able to glitch out again. Sweet.